My darlings, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. In today's video, I have something a little bit different because I want to talk to you all about everything I know about starting a Sims channel, a few reasons why I want to do this. I started my Sims channel on a different channel about 3 or 4 years ago. I think it was 4 years ago because it was like 2018 or 2019 or something like that. And I didn't know anything about computers. I honestly just got started with my MacBook from like 2011 and thought, well, I have a computer that runs the game. So really all I need is recording software. And I learned over the years, unfortunately, a little bit too late for myself, that that was not true. So at the start of this year, I went on a journey to learn as much as I could about starting a Sims channel and what kind of computer I needed. So in today's video, we're gonna go over everything and anything you need to know about starting a Sims YouTube channel or gaming channel in general if you're not a simmer, although I would wonder how you got on my channel if you're not a simmer. My only hope is that you find this video useful. Full disclaimer that no, I am definitely not perfect at recording The Sims. It was just really difficult for me to find this information. It literally took weeks and weeks and weeks of research and like going to a bunch of different channels. So I'm just gonna give you the full information that I have, no gatekeeping. But to set some ground rules, everything that I told you in this video is everything that I know from my own perspective. You should do your own research and take everything with a grain of salt. Any decision that you make is your own. I'm just giving you what I use and how I figured out how to start a Sims channel and record at the quality that I want it to record. Second, I've told you everything that I know. I am not Best Buy. I am not Apple. I am not any kind of gaming store. I am not a tech expert. No, I cannot answer your questions about why your computer is doing this or this or that, or is this piece compatible with this piece? I don't fucking know. Look it up, because I'm giving you the information that I am giving you. And truly my only hope is that this is helpful to you. As I mentioned, we're just gonna go through about 5 phases of this video where I'm gonna tell you as much as I can possibly tell you about what I know about starting a Sims channel and what you should keep in mind. But really my only intention is to help anyone that is thinking about doing this, because I think that there is space for all of us. And having this information as it is, I am recording this on October 7th, 2023. So it's current to this date. We're gonna start with the computer specs that you need. So The Sims 4, quite honestly, is one of my favorite games. I really love it and it's visually stunning, but it wasn't built very well in my opinion. Considering what kind of game it is, the demand it puts on your PC is super high. So let's start with just the base requirements that you need for The Sims 4, which by the way, are published on the EA website. If you just scroll down to here, you'll see system requirements. I personally record on a Windows. I prefer to record on Windows specifically because I like Reshade, and Reshade is not Mac compatible. G-Shade is Mac compatible, but I don't recommend G-Shade for a variety of reasons. So we're gonna go with Reshade if you want to use that to make your game brighter. But here are the minimum requirements that you need for a Windows PC. When I first saw this was definitely super confusing to me. I'm not gonna go super in depth in this section. Just know that these are the base level requirements that you will need in order to run the games. But they're recommending that you have at least this level of hardware in your computer in order to run the game well. Keep in mind that this may run your game, but when you're recording a Sims game, it's going to put a lot of demands on your computer. And what's going to happen is that it may not slow your gameplay down. You might be seeing everything fine, but in the recording that you're capturing, that screen recording in the background, your game is going to be dropping frames or moving really slowly, or it could be kind of stuttery or laggy and just visually not very fun to watch. So I'm recommending that you actually have higher specs than this. I'm going to tell you all of the specs that are in my computer, but let's talk about what to keep in mind and where I got started. How did I find out what to use for my computer? I spent so long watching all of Jay's Two Cents videos and Gamer Nexus videos. Gamer Nexus, I went for individual reviews for individual pieces of the computer, like graphics cards, cooling systems, CPUs, RAM, everything. Like, I was just researching what is the best of the best. What do you need? What's too much? How could I get the best possible computer for the lowest price? And what is a reasonable amount of investment? And then for Jay's Two Cents, I went for more information about how exactly to build a computer and what it is that you needed to consider, right? So this right here is a CPU, and it's just all the videos that I watched about how to build a computer, what parts you need, how to learn if something was compatible or not, what the best cooling system is, learning more about all-in-ones, which is a liquid cooling system that I have for my PC. I'm going to recommend that you go do a little bit of research if you are going to find your own parts and you're looking to learn more. I found these two channels deeply helpful with just learning more about computers. So the things to keep in mind when you're looking at a computer is chassis and airflow. Of course, you want to be mindful that all of the parts that you're using are actually compatible, like your motherboard being compatible with your CPU, being compatible with your graphics card. And I'll tell you a way you can figure that out and what website you can use if you want to go down the building your own PC route, the chassis, right? So you want to consider that because you want to be mindful of airflow. The glasses like this, super, super cool. But if there is no airflow in other areas of the computer, your computer is going to have to work very hard to cool it down, or you're going to need an incredible cooling system. I personally have some that looks a little bit like this, but my computer is white. I'm not a huge fan of the case, just to be honest with you, because you have to kind of disassemble almost the entire thing to get into the computer. And I like to clean my computer pretty regularly, so that is just annoying for going in to check things out. But just be mindful that when you're choosing the chassis for your computer, you want to make sure you're thinking about airflow. Is it getting good ventilation from multiple spaces, or is it essentially a hot box for all of your PCs? And trust me, when you are recording this, she's gonna get hot. Your computer's gonna get real hot unless you have a great cooling system. That's something that you should be really mindful of. If you are going to be building your own PC for your graphics card, I would recommend something like a 3080 or higher. But I think anything over like a 4000 is overkill. That's really for things like 3D rendering and like very, very high tech things. You don't need to spend that much money on a graphics card that is that high up, because yes, The Sims is demanding, but Bessie, it's not that demanding. You could really use that money towards getting something else, like upgrading your case, getting better RAM, upgrading your CPU. Those are things that you could put your money towards instead of going above like $4,000 for your graphics card. So the other thing I'm going to recommend that you get is an internal hard drive, an extra one, because you're going to have the hard drive that hosts things like your operating system, Windows, and I like to have a separate hard drive that hosts my Sims videos. Videos take up a huge amount of space. For reference, this is just my raw Sims 4 recording. This is how much space gets taken up in this folder. For reference, here's one video of just my Let's Plays, and you can see that this one finished video alone is almost 2 gigabytes. So I recommend that you have another hard drive that's separate from yours, just for making your gameplay a little bit smoother and for you to have additional space. And I would even add a third hard drive, which I plan to do later in the future for my computer, to add the other games that I play, because I just don't play the video games. But I do recommend that you have a separate hard drive that you put all of your Sims recordings and videos onto, that's different from the hard drive that is hosting your game. So there's a reason we were on Skytech Gaming. I got my computer from Skytech Gaming. Skytech Gaming has a couple of options for you. You can go the pre-built route, or you can go for a custom PC builder. I played around with the custom PC builder quite a bit just to get a sense of really what the specs were that they were offering, right? So say I was going for a Mark 7. I was literally going through this, comparing it to the videos that I was watching for Jay's Two Cents and Gamers Nexus and a few others, for exactly what was being offered to me when it came to every aspect, and getting a sense of, do I actually like these motherboards, right? Do I actually like the CPU for these systems? Are these graphics cards that I am actually interested in? And then I ultimately decided to go with a pre-built, because I figured it was more cost effective. I was pretty happy with the specs that it was being put into them, and I knew that I could easily replace one or two things here or there throughout the future if I wanted to update things and I wasn't happy with it. Building a computer isn't that difficult. It's actually something you should pretty easily be able to do yourself. I just honestly didn't want that stress. But for a long time, I did consider building my own computer route because of all the issues that I've had with pre-built before and just not having the specs that I wanted. A website that you can use is PC Parts Picker, because this will tell you if your pieces are compatible or not. For example, you can say, you know, I want an AMD Ryzen 7. Actually, let's choose a motherboard because that's going to have the compatibility, right? This will tell you these parts are not compatible, right? So it will save you a lot of time in the future. Check out PC Part Picker to see if those pieces are compatible and exactly how much it's going to cost. So let me tell you my full specs for the computer that I have. I honestly don't remember if I have one of these. I think I have a Prism. I don't know. I want to tell you my full specs though, because I don't remember which one I have. I specifically got mine from Best Buy in full like transparency. And I think it's a model that they don't have anymore, but mine is some kind of iteration of a Prism. Just so you know, my full computer spec. My motherboard is an ASRock Riptide Phantom X570S. My graphics card is a GeForce RTX 3080 Ventus. My CPU is an AMD 7 5800X. My RAM, I have 2 6 of 8 gigabytes for a total of 16 gigs of 3200. That's what I have for my RAM, which I do plan to update. I have 6 fans and I have an AIO, an all-in-one cooling system. The things that I change, your computer may not come built exactly this way. For example, my AIO was actually on the side and then all of the cooling systems, the fans that you see here, were up on top. And all of my fans were daisy chained together, which I personally was not a fan of and found that it made my computer very, very, very loud. So I went in and I played around. I moved my AIO so it would be top facing like this. And I moved my fan, so I have bottom cooling and I have top cooling, and that is what I ended up doing, which I'm really happy with. My computer runs very, very well. She's very cool and she's very quiet. And when I got this computer, it had the ability somewhere on here, I think here, where I could monitor my computer and I could get a sense of what was going on and making sure that it's not overheating. However, for full transparency, again, my computer was very loud, so that's the thing that I did. I updated the fan. I swapped them out for fans that were not daisy chained together because I did not personally like that, although that did mean that I lost the LED, but that was fine because my computer already has an LED. The AIO has an LED like screen where I can rotate out the images that display on it. And I honestly didn't make a computer to be fully LED'd out. It was just for me to have the power in it. It was very loud, as I mentioned. So something you're going to want to be mindful of is adjusting your fan curves. Just because a computer is loud does not mean that something is wrong. That just means that your fan curve is a little bit too intense. Here's how I fine-tuned mine. I have my Phantom Gaining tuning thing, as I mentioned. So I'm really monitoring how hot or cold it's getting. And I just adjusted the fan curves to what makes more sense for my computer. Depending on how hot it was getting, I could adjust the temperature. So say that it was getting, on average, my computer runs somewhere like here, and I wanted it to stay pretty quiet if it was in the zone. But if it got to like here, I would want it to get louder. You can also do that on the back end. So I initially adjusted it here, and then I went into my computer's back end to check things out and to adjust that as well. So if you're having an issue with your computer being loud, you're gonna wanna go and adjust your fan curves. All right, besties, and for reference, this is how my game runs with all of my specs. You can see it's really smooth and clean. I'm not dropping any frame rates. I'm really happy with how it looks, and you can see that even as I'm moving like very wildly, my computer is keeping up with me. And you are seeing this visually. Not only is my computer keeping up with me, my recording software is also able to keep up with me without dropping any frames and still having that super clear, crisp quality. So that's how my game runs with my specs. While we watch my beautiful Sim Brooklyn here go for her morning jog in New Cross, I'm gonna give you just some general disclaimer. My experience was overall positive with my computer. Prior to this, I had gone to 3 or 4 different gaming computers that all were kind of shit, in my opinion. And I've returned every single one of them because at some point they either crashed, they were blue screening, it wasn't working as well as I wanted to, it was too loud, it was overheating, everything and anything up until the point where I have the computer that I'm currently recording on and the one that I've had for the past several months. I absolutely love her to pieces, and it's my favorite gaming computer and exactly 100% what I wanted. However, just because my experience was positive and I chose to go with a pre-built that I just like lightly changed doesn't mean that that's going to be exactly your experience. I showed you how I did my research. I'm going to encourage you to do your research as well. Again, taking everything with a grain of salt. Just because it worked for me does not mean I'm telling you you should go out and do the exact same thing that I'm doing. I'm just giving you the exact information that I have or what I have on my computer and how it runs. I can't promise you that I am a techie. I think it's very obvious at this point that I am not, but this is just the guide to how I have a Sims channel and how my game runs the way that I want it to while still giving you quality video content, which I've realized I never told you how much my computer cost. My computer was around $1,700. That is how much I paid for her. And then I paid an additional like $100, $150, maybe $200 to add the other internal drive and to add different fans. So just like being mindful of it, the largest startup cost for having a gaming channel is of course your gaming computer. It can be expensive. I think that mine is like mid-range in price, definitely on the higher end. You can go way, way more. There are some that are like $4,000+. That is overkill. I think that at my price range, around the $2,000 mark, a few hundred dollars less than that, is a really good gaming computer. You can definitely go a little bit cheaper as well, but this is just what I have and how much I paid for it. It was about $1,800 total with everything that I purchased. Video that I recommend that you watch for Miss Lollipop is how to install Reshade. This is her newest tutorial for how to install Reshade. You can see that Lauren's videos always look so good. Like, look at her Sims, look at her Reshade. It is absolutely beautiful. And she again walks you through so thoroughly and so well through everything you need to know about downloading and installing Reshade, taking screenshots, everything and anything. So if you want to install Reshade, you can do this. This is also about making G-Shade compatible, but again, I don't use G-Shade. I have a bad experience with it. It's not something that I personally recommend. But again, you do you. Here's my Sim game while my Reshade is loading. And the reason I'm showing you this is you can see without Reshade, this is what my game looks like. It's dark and like, yes, absolutely, people do play like this, but I played with Reshade for so long that I can't imagine playing like this. Like, it just feels very dark to me, but you absolutely don't need Reshade. And this is not a Reshade tutorial, but it is just telling you that how I record my Sims, part of that is having Reshade. I like my Sims game to be nice and bright and the shadows to be very deep so that I can have the personal style that I want for my Sims. Beyond the custom content that I use for them, I want to make sure that my Sims game visually is what I want it to be. And I think the Sims game without Reshade is very, very dark. Here is my exact Reshade. I use the Kindle Spice Dove for my Reshade. There are definitely plenty. I have others installed into my game. For example, I have Radiance, which is, this is what it looks like with Radiance in my game. I just prefer my Dove Reshade, but there are a ton you can get. Lots of creators have them that you can go and look into. And we're going to talk more about Miss Lollipop too, because I think that her videos are really fantastic. And I'll show you which videos I would recommend if you're trying to set up your recording software and you're trying to set up your Reshade. So this is my exact settings with Dove. I will let you know that I did fine tune this a little bit. For example, I have Technicolor on just because I like my game to be even brighter so you can see without it versus with it. And I adjust the Technicolor down here. I also have Cartoon on, which you can see just adds a little bit of shadow. It's so subtle, but if you're watching my Sim's face, Cartoon just adds more shadows and depth. And that's pretty much all I did to my Reshade to get it to look visually how it looks in my videos and in my game as I am playing it. But let me show you my recording settings and the videos that I recommend for you for Miss Lollipop. This is a little bit of Inception, but hello, welcome to my OBS. So with OBS, this is the software that I use to record my Sims game. It is a really great software and it is completely free. Just Google OBS and you can download it. It costs you absolutely nothing and it's completely fine. It's something that a lot of Sims YouTubers use. So for my output, I'm going to recording and this is exactly how I have my recording. And here's exactly the encoder settings that I use. I keep this on CBR. I keep this at best quality. And that's roughly where I keep my encoder settings. This is how my game looks when I have the settings set to here. With my audio, I just have everything set up to the max capacity. I'm going to talk to you about Miss Lollipop, who actually has better information for you about OBS and how to set your OBS up. This is Miss Lollipop's channel right here, Lauren. Her videos are great. I recommend that you just watch them. You can see like they're just a lot of fun. This video is 3 years old, but it still stands. And you can see that she walks you through everything you need to know about setting up your OBS settings, your recording settings, everything and anything that you would need to know. So I recommend that you watch this video if you want to get your OBS set up a certain way. This is the microphone that I use and I do have it set up on a separate arm on my desk. You can just search microphone arm. They're usually around $20 or $30. And you can see that this microphone costs about $50. So this is what you are hearing me on and what I have set up. Because I don't have a super expensive microphone, I have a pretty simple one. I found this video when I was setting up my system software, and this is really, really, really good, so useful and easy to follow for enhancing your mic. So I'm here specifically so you can see my filters for how I've updated my microphone to sound better than what it is at base quality. So I have my 3-brand equalizer on if you want to look at this. I also have my expander. Here are my exact ratios. Although I tell you, audio is the bane of my existence. I don't think this is perfect, but just full transparency there. I'm not an audio expert and I definitely do want to fine tune these. This is my compressor and like everything that I have set up for my correct compressor, the exact specs. And then the limiter is what makes it so that you are not like getting your eardrums blown out when I am being too loud. Like say if I scream into the microphone, you don't want to hear that. This will make it so that it will automatically set back to a certain threshold so that you don't hear that and you're not hearing like the click, 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 clack of me typing in the background. So that's my exact audio system, my audio software, and how I record The Sims for free and the videos that I recommend that you watch. Okay, babe. And this is how I edit my videos completely for free. I use DaVinci Resolve 18, which is an editing software that is completely free and available for you to download. You can just Google it and you're able to get this software. Again, you're downloading everything and anything at your own risk. I use this. It's been completely fine for me and I really enjoy it. I find the editing can be quite intuitive. A lot of the shortcuts are exactly the same as they are for like something like Final Cut Pro or iMovie or something like that. So it's very easy to use. This isn't a tutorial on how to use DaVinci Resolve, but it is showing you that I use DaVinci Resolve and this is how I edit my Sims video for free. It's not perfect because I wish that I could go in and like fine tune more specifically. For example, at the end of certain clips, you'll like hear a pause, but that's because I can't cut it anymore without cutting into my words. She's not perfect, but she works very well. And then let me show you my project settings. I always have this set to 60 FPS. By default, it's at 24, but I record in 60 FPS. So I want to make sure that my video quality is at that same standard. And then once I am done, I just go and I export it. I keep it to the YouTube settings because YouTube can sometimes lower the quality of your footage if you're using the wrong format. And that is annoying and will shoot you in the foot. But we'll talk about that later. And then I'll just export it to that same D drive that I have, the other one that I installed on my computer specifically for my Sims videos. So let's say that I want to upload a video. This is my YouTube account. I'm going to talk to you about YouTube in general. And the thing to be mindful of, right, is you want to make sure that your titles are accurate to what you're doing. And there's a reason that my videos are titled and tagged in certain ways, right? I have this here, which is my vidIQ. vidIQ tells you everything to know about like my score for my video in terms of searchability. YouTube is a search engine in some ways, and your SEO, search engine optimization, should be pretty good. You don't want to keyword stuff, but you want to make sure that you're mentioning the relevant things, right? So here I have Townie CC makeovers, Sims 4, Legacy Challenge, Cast. So just mentioning things that people might be searching. I also just have Sims 4 tagged in here, number one, so you can know exactly what kind of video that you want. But also for search engine optimization, at the bottom of all of my videos, I always have the hashtags, and then I have the tags that are relevant to that video. In addition, I keep everything in a playlist that's more for you all to make sure that everything is easy to find and that you're able to binge watch if you want to binge watch without having to like go through and try to find something specific on my channel, especially for my Let's Plays. I like to make sure they're all in the same playlist. And then you have your tags. You want to make sure that you're using your tags. And again, tags is just like the keywords that people are using. Some people think tags are irrelevant, but I personally find tags really helpful with getting my videos searchable so that when you are searching for something specific, say you wanted to see a CC Townie makeover, you would find my video somewhere within the top of that search. I can't always control that, but you do want to make sure that when you're posting videos, you're being mindful of your SEO and that your video is optimized with the right keywords. Again, don't keyword stuff. Like, I wouldn't take my tags and just copy and paste them into my description, and I wouldn't just make a description that literally makes no sense and difficult to read, because that will be flagged. You want to be very mindful of how you do that, but that is how I do it with my video elements. This is what it looks like. I always add an end screen, and I always add a card, which is just promotion to another video. So if you're watching a CC Townie makeover, I would link like my CC shopping video, so you would see how I do my CC shopping and where I get my custom content from. This is vidIQ. It's completely free. I don't have it set up with my Sims channel because I have a different channel that I use for my gaming, but it can give you ideas for what's trending. It gives you some daily ideas, limited recommendations. It's keeping track of your stats and how you are doing. It gives you keyword recommendations, so I could search like Sims for keywords, but it's giving me some other terms that I can use in my description. SEO can be complicated, but vidIQ is free and makes it really, really easy. Definitely recommend vidIQ. This is all completely free. It's going to make SEO so much simpler for you. Now, people will tell you the key to YouTube is consistency. And to an extent, that's true, but I'm not a gatekeeper. So I'm going to tell you the key to YouTube is SEO, having proper keywords tagged. You're going to need to jump on some trends. You're going to want to make videos that are helpful to your audience. For example, I'm making this video specifically because I want to be helpful to you. I really struggled with getting this channel set up, and I made a lot of mistakes over the past 4 years on my other Sims channel that I want to prevent you from making that mistakes, or at least make it easier for you to step around those mistakes. You can be as consistent as you want to be, and you can have really fantastic SEO, but if your videos are not watchable, that's going to show in your statistics, and YouTube's algorithm is going to pay attention to that. So for example, say you don't have a computer that can handle the game really well, and when you're recording, your frames are dropping and your video is really slow, really laggy, the audio quality isn't great, you kind of sound like you're speaking from inside of a can. People may click that video because it's well tagged with SEO, but they're not going to watch it. And you'll know that by your watch time, right? So it will tell you how many views you have and the average viewer duration. If you're seeing that the video watch time is only like 30 seconds, a minute, it means your video is not watchable and people are not watching it. And that's simply because it's too difficult to watch. And because it's too difficult to watch, people are not going to watch the video. And YouTube is going to see that you are posting videos on a consistent basis, but people are consistently not watching it. And they're going to eventually start hiding your videos to the point where you will struggle to gain any subscribers and you will struggle to recover. Even if in the future you update your system and you update your microphone and you get everything all crisp and clear, you're going to have to fight against the algorithm, because for the first however much amount of time, your videos were really bad quality and people were not watching them. So I'm going to tell you that you want to be mindful of that. Like, yes, you definitely can start with what you have, but be careful of of starting at a point that's too low. Would you watch a video where the audio sounded like it was super far away and underwater? Or would you think that's a pretty low quality video? It's okay for you to learn and grow as you go, but I am just speaking from experience as someone who did post really bad videos for like 4 years. Not bad because of their content, but bad because of their quality level, because I simply did not know any better, which is the primary motivation for me posting this video. So I do recommend that you are mindful of that you pay attention to your SEO, and that you make sure that you have some good specs to start with. Like I mentioned, the highest startup cost for starting a Sims channel is definitely going to be your actual gaming computer. You don't need to go to a $4,000 computer. That is overkill, Bessie, overkill. But you can go fairly mid-range, so long as you have a powerful graphics card and you have really good like hardware behind you, you should be okay. As I mentioned, the exact specs are going to be in the description of this video for my computer, and I also mentioned them earlier on. And we end where we started. I hope you found this video helpful. I do know that it wasn't perfect, but I did try my best to just tell you everything that I know about having a Sims channel, everything about my computer specs, how I edit my game, what software I use, how I edit my thumbnails, etc., etc., etc. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, this is the extent of my knowledge. I have pointed you to people that I think would be really helpful. I'm also going to have those videos linked in the description below just for ease of use. I hope that you did find this useful. If you start a Sims channel, please link your channel in the comments or just share your channel name, because I would love to check it out. I think that there is space for every single one of us, and I do not believe in gatekeeping. So this is everything that I know. If you have specific tech questions or specific game questions, or you're wondering why your game is doing this or not doing this, or why OBS is doing this but not doing this, I'm sorry, I don't know the answer to it. You're going to have to find the answer somewhere else, because I've told you everything that I know so far. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you did find it helpful. I look forward to seeing your Sims YouTube channel. I'm going to see you in my next video, which should hopefully be Whimsy Stories. Bye!